Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Nikita Singhal. Today I'm going to start the BioInorganic Chemistry. In this presentation, I will cover its introduction, essential and non-essential elements, role of some metal ions in biological system. BioInorganic Chemistry is a merger of biochemistry and inorganic chemistry. In this, we study the inorganic entities and their function in biological systems. It will include the study of naturally occurring inorganic elements and introduction of metals into biological system in form of drugs, and how the different metal ions or non-metals plays different roles in biological system. What are the essential elements? There are some certain elements present in our body which are essential for survival. Without them, or we can say if they are not present in proper quantity, they can create some disease, or their absence can create death. They are known as essential element. Whether there are some elements which are known as non-essential element, their presence can be replaced with some other elements, and their function can be taken by other elements. So they are not required for survival. For example, aluminium and strontium are known as non-essential element. While the essential elements can be categorized on the basis of quantity. First category is bulk elements, and second is trace element. Bulk essential elements are those elements which are required in the larger quantity for survival. For example, carbon, hydrogen, sulfur, sodium, magnesium, etc. While the trace elements which are required in minute quantity, but they are must for survival. For example, iron, copper, zinc, all are essential trace elements. There are 12 transition metals which comes in the trace elements. Some other elements like lithium, boron, silicon, arsenic all also comes as a trace element. Except that there is one more category for elements are toxic elements like cadmium, mercury, lead, which all can create poisoning of our body and not good for our health. Metal ion plays different role in our body. Like they can act as a cofactors for enzymes, so they are required to activate the enzymes or helps to enhance the activity. They act as an oxygen carrier or electron transportation. They regulate the pH or osmotic pressure of body. Metal ion helps in controlling of the metabolic pathway, as well as they plays important role for a structural skeleton formation. We'll discuss different essential elements and their roles in biological system. First, we are going to start with sodium ion. What is its source? How much amount it is required? What are its function? And its deficiency and excess can cause certain disease or certain problems in our body. So we all know sodium chloride is a major source for the sodium, and sodium chloride is table salt, which we all use in cooking purpose. So the content of sodium is also high in cheese, bread and some nuts. Almost 5 to 10 grams of sodium chloride is required per day for adults. It is the major component of blood, which is present in extracellular fluid. Sodium is important to regulate the flow of water across the membrane. It is used for generation of nerve impulse, as well as maintains the electrolytic balance in our body. It helps to maintain the osmotic pressure as well as acid-base balance in our body. Sodium is required to absorb the glucose, amino acid and galactose in our body. Sodium and potassium pump works in our body to make the proper functioning of nerve impulse generation. And if sodium is in excess amount in our body, that causes a high blood pressure. If we lose the sodium due to the excess sweating, then its deficiency will create the muscular cramps in abdomen, and headache can be there. If sodium level drops below a certain level, then it can create hyponatremia, which the patient can undergo the coma also. Role of potassium metal ion in the biological system. The main food source in which potassium is present is like dark leafy greens, baked potatoes, avocado, fish, dark chocolates, banana, apricots, yogurt, etc. Almost 4 grams of potassium is required per day. It is mainly present inside the cell. Its major role is to balance the electrolyte and fluid in our body. It helps in the conduction of nerve impulse with the sodium ions. It acts as a cofactor for certain enzymes like pyruvate kinase. It maintains the osmotic pressure, as well as it is important for heart functioning and muscle contractions. If potassium is less than the required amount, then it can cause the hypertension, some stroke, cardiovascular disease, and weakness can be there. The disease which is comes from the deficiency of potassium is known as hypokalemia. If potassium is present in high amount, then excess also causes some problem like nausea, fatigue, difficult breathing, etc. can be observed. Now we are coming to the calcium metal ion, which is also a bulk essential element. It's almost 1 gram. 1 gram amount is required per day. Its major source are milk, banana, beans, cheese, egg, etc. Calcium is a major constituent of bones and teeth. Almost 90% of calcium is present in our skeleton, which gives rigidity to the to our body. Calcium is mainly present in of calcium hydroxyapatite and in teeth. Calcium binds with the protein for the blood coagulation, so it helps for the blood clotting. It is important for muscle contraction also. It is known as a messenger because it helps for transmission of electrical impulse. It maintains the normal excitability of heartbeat. If calcium is present in low level than the required limit, then it causes the irritation, bone weakening in children known as rickets, and bone weakening in adults known as osteoporosis. If calcium is present in high amount, then it also creates problem. It forms a stone in gallbladder or kidney. It creates the abnormal heart rhythm and depression. Role of magnesium metal ion in our body. Magnesium is a very important metal which is a part of many biochemical reaction. Almost 500 milligram magnesium, that means 0.5 gram magnesium is required per day. Its major source are green vegetables, pumpkin seeds, chia seeds, some nuts, soybean, and dark chocolate. As we all know, chlorophyll is a major pigment which is present in leaves, which is required for photosynthesis process. The central metal ion is magnesium. So it plays a major role in photosynthesis. It is also used for the glycolysis and in production of enzyme. It also regulates the cholesterol. The binding of magnesium is required for DNA and RNA stabilization. It maintains the electrolytic balance, as well as is most important for synthesis and activation of ATP. The deficiency of magnesium causes the abnormal heart rhythm, decreased appetite, osteoporosis, and some cramps. If magnesium is present in very high amount, then it causes the stomach cramps, nausea, chest pain, and cardiac arrest. Now we are coming to the non-metal, that is phosphorus. It is also a major element, bulk element, and it is present in almost all food wherever the protein is present, like milk, egg, etc. Near about 1 gram potassium is required per day in our body. Its main source is the formation of bone and teeth with calcium. It is important for protein synthesis, growth, and maintenance of cell and tissue. It is a source of ATP and ADP, that means source of energy. It makes the backbone of nuclear genetic material, that is DNA and RNA. If phosphorus is present in low concentration, so its deficiency can cause two major diseases, that is hypophosphatemia, in which neurological dysfunction and muscles are disrupted. And in osteomalacia disease, bones get softened. If the calcium, phosphate, and vitamin D is not present in adequate level. If phosphate are present in very high amount, it also creates the calcification, that is known as a hardening of organ and soft tissues. Now we are coming to the trace elements which are required in our body as essential elements. So first we will discuss the copper. Its major sources are legumes, chocolates, cereals, peanuts, rice, shellfish, etc. Almost 80 to 130 milligram of copper is required per day. And its major functions are involving, it is involved in formation of RBC, that are red blood cells. It is necessary for growth, development of bones and connective tissue. The copper stimulates the immune system so it can fight the infections and repair the injured tissues for healing. Copper is present in many enzymes. They are known as cuproenzyme, which help to carry out the redox reaction, and they are involved in the metabolic process. Copper also help to neutralize some free radical which can cause the cell damage. If copper is present in excess, then it can cause the nausea, diarrhea, and tissue injuring. The major diseases which can occur due to the absence or due to the excess of the copper are Wilson disease and Alzheimer disease. In the Alzheimer disease, there is a memory loss occur. If copper is deficient in our body, then severe blood disorders, arthritis, cardiovascular disease, and cancer can be happen. Vanadium is also a transition metal from 3D series. It should be present almost in 100 microgram in our body, and its major source are radish, herbs, parsley, mushroom, black pepper, etc. It reduces the production of cholesterol. It also increases the immunity towards the infections, and it also helps to absorb the harmful microbes. The vanadium is required for correct functioning of the central nervous system. If it is deficient, then it increases the risk for diabetes. If excess vanadium is present, there are some gastrointestinal discomfort and renal failure, respiratory and cardiovascular distress is observed. Now we will look about the iron metal. As we all know, iron is a major component of our blood. So how it impacts in our body? Its major food sources are oysters, lentils, poultry, leafy vegetables, chickpeas, and red meat. In women, it should be present in 15 to 18 milligram, while in men, it should be present in 8 milligram. In children, it should be around 4 to 8 milligram. This requirements are for the per day. Iron containing protein participate in transportation of gases, mainly oxygen. It supplies oxygen from lungs to our body. It also helps for building enzyme. It stores the iron in our body and transfers the electrons. Iron is required to strengthen the immune system. It contributes for the cognitive functions which are related to the brain and nervous system. Iron is required for protein metabolism and cellular respiration process. It is also required for cell division, cell growth, and synthesis of DNA molecule. If iron is deficient in our body, so that causes a fatigue, weakness, and anemia, in which RBC is decreased. So we observe the irregular heartbeats, delayed growth of infants, as well as cognitive development and behavioral problems are also observed. If iron is present in high amount, it will be in a free state, which is very toxic. So it can damage the DNA and cellular components. Presence of excess iron causes a disease which is known as a siderosis. Now we will look towards the zinc metal ion. Zinc is also essential trace metal ion. Its major source are meat, fish, eggs, wheat, mustard, sunflower seeds, etc. Almost 12 milligram and 15 milligrams zinc is required in women and men respectively. Its major role is to synthesize and stabilize the genetic material. It is required for tissue growth. Zinc is also present in some enzymes like carbonic anhydrase, carboxypeptidase, which are required for CO2 regulation as well as protein synthesis. The zinc is important for normal development of male reproductive system and testosterone hormone. It is necessary for formation of immune system. It regulates the hormonal balance, white blood cells, and thyroid glands. if zinc is deficient in our body, then it causes the growth retardation, hair loss, impotency, and delayed wound healing. It also causes the impaired immune function. If zinc is present in excess, then also it creates the taste alteration. It also reduces the copper level in our body. So simultaneously, low copper level will create the diseases which comes from the copper deficiency, as well as the lower immunity will be observed if zinc is present in excess. So today I'm going to conclude that we have seen what is the bioinorganic chemistry and how different inorganic elements plays different role in our biological system. Different metal ions are required to play the different functions because they are the part of some of the structural skeleton in our body, some of the enzymes which are required for proper functioning of our body. So I can say the proper balanced diet is required to take to keep our body healthy. Thank you.